Hi everyone. Today we are discussing a trigonometric question, and the question is based on the compound angle formulae. We are given with that if sine A minus B is equal to 1 over square root 10 and cos A plus B is equal to 2 over square root 29, then find the value of tan 2A, where A and B lies between 0 and pi over 4. So let's get started without wasting much time. Here, first, let's see what we need to find out and how we can use the given information. So we are trying to find out tan 2a. But the given information in this question is in the form of either a plus b or a minus b. So let's try to include a plus b and a minus b in this. So in order to do that, I can write 2a as a plus a, right? So we can write it as tan a plus a. And here, if we add b and then subtract b, it'll not make any difference to 2a, right? So now we have tan a plus b plus a minus b, correct? So now this is in the form of tan alpha plus beta, and we can expand it using the formula tan a plus b equals tan a plus tan b over 1 minus tan a tan b. By doing that, we'll get tan 2a equals tan a plus b plus tan a minus b over 1 minus tan a plus b times tan a minus b. So now we need to find out what is tan a plus b and tan a minus b, and then we'll be able to find out tan 2a. So in order to find out tan a plus b, we can use the information cos a plus b. And in order to find out tan a minus b, we can use the information sine a minus b. But before we do that, we need to figure out where a plus b will lie and where a minus b will lie. So we need to decide in what quadrants a plus b will lie and in what quadrant a minus b will lie. And based on that, you'll get the value of tan a plus b and tan a minus b. Because based on the quadrant, the value of tan can be positive or negative, right? So that will make a difference to overall answer. So let's decide in what quadrant A plus B lies and in what quadrant A minus B lies. So we are given with that A lies between 0 to pi over 4, and B also lies between 0 to pi over 4. That means A plus B should lie between 0 and 90. And if a plus b is in 0 to 90, that means we are in what quadrant? We are in first quadrant. And in first quadrant, all the trigonometric ratios are positive, right? And now, if we find out a minus b. Now, a minus b can lie between negative pi over 4 to positive pi over 4. Because we don't know if a is greater or b is greater, right? So their difference might lie anywhere between negative pi over 4 to pi over 4. However, we are already given with sine a minus b value is 1 over square root 10. And this is a positive value, right? We are given with a positive value of sine. As we are given with positive value of sine, and by using all sine, tan, cos, we know that sine is only positive in first quadrant and in second quadrant. But if you look at negative pi over 4, it is in which quadrant? It is in fourth quadrant. That means we can narrow down the range of a minus b from negative pi over 4 to pi over 4 to 0 to pi over 4. The reason being, because we already know that sine A minus B is positive. And that is only possible in first quadrant according to A minus B range. So if this is clear, let's move on and now try to find out tan A minus B and tan A plus B. So we are given with sine A minus B equals 1 over square root 10. That means the opposite side is 1. The hypotenuse is square root 10. That means we can find the adjacent side by using Pythagoras. So by using Pythagoras, we can easily find that the remaining side will be 3. And tan A minus B is equal to opposite side, which is 1, divided by the adjacent side, which is 3. Similarly, we are given with cos A plus B equals 2 over square root 29. And we know that cos A plus B is adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. And we can easily find the missing side. So the missing side will be equal to 5. And that is by using Pythagoras theorem. So tan A plus B is equal to, again, opposite side, which is 5, over adjacent side, which is 2. So we found the value of tan A minus B and tan A plus B. Now we can go back and substitute these values in tan2A formula that we obtained in the first step. So tan2A is equal to tan A plus B, which is 5 over 2, plus tan A minus B, which is 1 over 3, divided by 1 minus tan A plus B, which is 5 over 2, times tan A minus B, which is 1 over 3, equals. Now we can take LCM in the numerator, which will be 6. So you have 15 plus 2 over 6, divided by, similarly in the denominator, we have 6 minus 5 over 6, and we can cancel out 6. 15 plus 2 is 17, divided by 6 minus 5 is 1. So tan2A is equal to 17. These type of problems might look difficult at first, but if you use the given information carefully, they're very easy. This is it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.